Hello children, good morning. In our previous class, we were seeing about sentences, right? Were you able to understand that? Shall we start our class? First, we are going to see about the list of parts of speeches. Next, we are going to see about the first parts of speech, that is the noun. Thirdly, we are going to see the kinds of nouns. Then, explanation about nouns with examples. Finally, we'll wind up the session by doing some exercises. First, let us see the parts of speeches. Children, do you know how many parts of speech we have? Yes, there are 8 parts of speeches. Shall we see one by one? The first one is nouns. The second one is pronouns. The third one is adjectives. The fourth one is verbs. The fifth one is adverbs. The sixth one is prepositions. The seventh one is conjunctions. And the eighth one is interjection. Are you all ready to learn about nouns? Here, you may have a doubt. What is a noun? The answer is here. Noun is a naming word. It can be a name of a person. For example, you are a person, right? Your name, your friend's name, your father's name, your mother's name. It can be anybody's name. And then it can be a name of a place. Where do you live, children? In Chennai, right? It's a name of a place, isn't it? So, this is also called as noun. And then, it can be a name of an animal. For example, cat, dog, lion, and so on. Finally, it can be a name of a thing. What are the things you have in your home, children? List out those things. For example, table, fan, television, all in the list are called as nouns. Now, let us see the types of nouns. Noun can be divided like concrete noun and abstract noun. What is a concrete noun? A noun which we can see and touch are called concrete noun. Now, see these examples. Table. Can you see a table? Can you touch a table? Yes, isn't it? So, this is a concrete noun. Next one is mountain. Can you see a mountain? Can you touch a mountain? Yes. So, this is also a concrete noun. And our third example is friend. You can see and touch your friend, isn't it? So, these are the some examples of concrete noun. You try to make your own examples for concrete noun. Now, we are going to see about abstract noun. Nouns which we can only feel, hear and think of. But we can never see or touch that noun. Read these examples along with me, children. Friendship, happiness, hunger. First one is friendship. You can see and touch your friend, isn't it? But you cannot see that friendship. That can only be felt. And when you are in hunger, you will say like, I feel hungry. And when you are so happy, you will say, I feel very happy, isn't it? So these kind of things only be felt. We can't say it. These kinds of nouns are called as abstract noun. Shall we start to see the concrete nouns? The first one is common noun. Children, you try to say along with me. Okay. The second one is proper noun. Third one is material noun. Fourth one is countable noun. Fifth one is uncountable noun. Sixth one is collective noun. So these are the 6 different kinds of concrete nouns. In this class, we are going to see only about common noun, proper noun and material noun. The remaining nouns and all we see in our next class. Shall we start to see common noun? Common noun refers people or place or thing in a common way, in a general way. It doesn't particularize any person, thing or place. Okay, and it does not need any capital letter. You can see the example, boy. When you mention the word boy, here we are not particularizing any one person. It is a common name of a group of people, right? The same way, city and oceans. This is a common name for a different kind of cities. And oceans, this is a common name for many oceans. So, these kind of words are called as common noun. Now, let us see proper noun. Proper noun refers things or places or human being in a specific manner. It particularizes the person and it must start with a capital letter. See the example. The first one is Arun. Arun. Here we are particularizing a boy, isn't it? And see the second one, Madurai. It is a name of a city. So we are particularizing a place. And the third one is Pacific Ocean. Here we are particularizing or we are specifically mentioning a single thing. So these kind of words are called as proper noun. And the last one is material noun. We use material nouns to talk about what things are made up of. Table is a noun. What is the table made up of? Either by wood or plastic. So wood and plastic are called material nouns. And you can see the second example as gold. By using gold, we can make lots and lots of things. And finally, glass. By using glass also, we can make lots of things like plate, door, window. So many things can be made up of glass. So these kind of raw materials are used to make a particular object, isn't it? So these kind of words are called as material nouns. Are you able to understand this? Now, let us try to do this example. Find out the nouns from the given list. The first one is child, second one is under, third one is meat, and the fourth one is June, fifth one is cotton. Children, you pause your video here and try to find out the nouns from this list. So here I have given the answers in red color. Child, June and cotton. These are the nouns from this list. I will attach a file along with this video. Try to do those exercises, okay? Thank you, children. Have a nice day.